Google, Microsoft, Facebook, Skype, Google Mail, Yahoo Mail, PayPal. These are all U.S. Navy and military operations tracking people by the electromagnetic frequency emitted by individuals' DNA. In other words, every living thing is an antenna that transmits and receives. The DNA in every living thing has a unique frequency and signal. That is what they're using, what they're focusing on, and what they're weaponizing to completely control us. The DNA Human Genome Project was carried out at the Lawrence Berkeley National Lab, where I was a staff scientist for 5 years. But the Lawrence Livermore Lab, Los Alamos National Lab, these are all nuclear weapons labs, were also involved. That means the military, because the nuclear weapons labs exist for the Pentagon, and the Pentagon exists for the oil company. The Human Genome Project was set up and well-funded to experiment and to research and to describe the human genome. The J. Greg Venter Institute has their mission as, quote, to forge new life forms, unquote. And they are also involved in manipulated computer code on DNA. And what they're doing is using computing, medicine, technology, and the police state to converge into basically what is creating a totalitarian scientific oligarchy. And their purpose is to get this information and use it in discriminatory programs where the rich benefit and the poor are impacted negatively by these programs. And the second part of that agenda is the depopulation initiatives. Now, I did an interview with Dr. Wynn Parker on the air. I was talking about depleted uranium and the tremendous affinity it has for the DNA and mitochondria, because uranium and phosphate structures, they have a love affair all through the universe. And that means that when people are exposed to uranium particles from these wars in Iraq and Afghanistan and Yugoslavia, and by the way, it's over here in 2 weeks, it sticks to our DNA and our mitochondria that provide all the energy for the body. So as I was sitting there describing all of this to Dr. Parker, and I was talking about HARP, this is all integrated into the HARP system, I knew that Dr. Parker, Wynn Parker, was not his real name. I knew he was a CIA scientist. I knew he'd worked for the U.S. government, for the Department of Defense, for the World Health Organization, and the U.N. at different times. And I knew that he was a microbiologist who knew the whole field because he had to advise the government. And so I just said, Dr. Parker, what is the application of this discovery that nanoparticles are transmitters? And he caught his breath and he said, well, it's to redesign the human genome.